Stepping up its efforts to redraw the Jammu and Kashmir electoral boundaries, the Delimitation Commission will visit the Union Territory for the first time after Prime Minister's all-party meeting. The members of the Commission will be reaching Srinagar today at noon. The Commission is set to meet all the political leaders at 3:30 p.m. The panel has invited leaders of all national, regional and registered political parties of Kashmir. The Commission, led by Justice retired Ranjana Prakash Desai and Chief Electoral Commissioner Sushil Chandra, may also hold separate meetings with civil society groups and similar organizations after prior approval and time slots through their respective DCs. The commission is going to be staying in the Jammu and Kashmir for 4 days. They will gather first-hand inputs on the conduct of mega exercise to carve out new constituencies.
Bharatiya Janata Party wants a fair delimitation in Jammu and Kashmir. We want a delimitation commission should follow the absolute norms while framing the assembly segments in Jammu and Kashmir, and they will do justice to the common man. There will be justice for all. There should be no discrimination among the regions and the various sections of the societies that had already happened in past.
Ashrafani now reporting live. Ashraf, the first time around after that crucial meeting is when the Delimitation Commission is going to be visiting Jammu and Kashmir. What's on the cards? If you could just brief our viewers.
Chetty, basically this is very important and significant visit of the Delimitation Commission here in the Kashmir Valley, and they will be on the ground this afternoon. As you said, they are going to meet all the national and the regional political parties here in the Srinagar, and including some of the parties which are part of the Gupkar Alliance. That is the very important thing. Otherwise, earlier there were some hesitations put by some regional parties, including the National Conference and PDP, for the delimitation in the Jammu and Kashmir. But now this process is starting from today, and this commission will not only be in Srinagar, they will also go on the ground in different parts of the valley, particularly Shopian, Pahalgam, and there also the members of civil societies, common people and other people, political workers can meet them there at the respective places. They have already asked the deputy commissioners to bring those people who want to meet and guide them for this process, which is going to start here in the Jammu and Kashmir from today. And one of the important things what is coming out is that the main questions which are being raised by the main political parties, particularly the Gupkar Alliance, including the National Conference and PDP, is that why the government of India is so much hurry in the in this process instead of conducting elections. I yesterday spoke to the Gupkar Alliance spokesman Muhammad Yusuf Tarigami. I asked him about this process. He said, okay, it is a part of the initiative by the Prime Minister and the central government here in the Jammu and Kashmir. But the big question is the statehood was promised when the Article 370 was abrogated. Why not statehood for the Jammu and Kashmir first and then elections? So the process is for the elections, before elections, as the Prime Minister's office said that after this delimitation there will be the elections, right, in the Jammu and Kashmir. But the big question is whether the, right, the parties, regional parties, will stick that first it should be the statehood to the Jammu and Kashmir, then elections.
All right, Ashraf, we'll come back to you for more on this story. Moving on now to the other big story we're tracking right here on India Today.